Welcome to a lesson on Kruskal's algorithm that's used to find the minimum cost spanning tree. For review, a spanning tree is a connected graph using all vertices in which there are no circuits. In other words, there's a path from any vertex to any other vertex, but no circuits. The dark blue path here is an example of a spanning tree. The minimum cost spanning tree is the spanning tree with the smallest total edge weight. A nearest neighbor style approach doesn't make much sense here since we don't need a circuit, so instead we'll take an approach similar to the sorted edges algorithm. So the algorithm to find the minimum cost spanning tree is called Kruskal's algorithm. Step one, we select the cheapest unused edge in the graph. Step two, we repeat step one, adding the cheapest unused edge, unless A, adding the edge, would create a circuit. So again, we don't want circuits in a spanning tree. And then three, we repeat until a spanning tree is formed. Kruskal's algorithm is an efficient and optimal algorithm, which means it's easy to use, and it does always give the minimum cost spanning tree. Let's take a look at some examples. We want to find the minimum cost spanning tree on the graph below using Kruskal's algorithm. Which of the edges below were included in the minimum cost, and what is the minimum cost? So again, we begin by selecting the edge with the least weight, or the cheapest edge, which we can see here would be edge BC. And now we'll select the next cheapest edge as long as it doesn't form a circuit. So the next edge would be edge AC with a weight of 7. Next would be edge CD with a weight of 8. And we're done because now there's a path from any vertex to any other vertex without any circuits. So this is a spanning tree. And now to find the minimum cost, we sum the weights of these three edges. So that would be 5 plus 7 plus 8, which is equal to 20. Now let's take a look at a more involved example. The graph below shows the cost in thousands of dollars to pave roads between houses. Determine the minimum cost spanning tree on the graph using Kruskal's algorithm. Looking at all the weights, the least weight is 2, so we'll begin by using edge AB as well as edge EI. The next smallest weight looks like it's 4, so we'll use edge GH. The next smallest weight is 5, which is here, edge EF. The next smallest weight would be 6. Notice how two edges have a weight of 6. Using edge CG does not form a circuit, and neither does using edge JK. So we're still okay. The next smallest weight would be 7. Notice using edge GK does not form a circuit, so we'll use that edge. The next smallest weight would be 8, and there are three edges with weight 8, edge BC, edge DH, and edge IJ. Notice using edge BC does not form a circuit. Notice using edge DH does not form a circuit, and neither does using edge IJ. The next smallest weight would be 9, but looking at edge BF, if we use edge BF, we would form a circuit here, and therefore we cannot use edge BF. The next smallest weight here would be 12. Notice if we use edge HL, it does not form a circuit, and it also completes the spanning tree. So now we have all the edges we need, so we're left to find the minimum cost, so we'll find the sum of all the weights. So we'd have 2 plus 8 plus 6 plus 8 plus 5 plus 4 plus 2 plus 7 plus 12 plus 8 plus 6. Let's just make sure we have all of these. We use a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 edges. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 values. And the sum comes to 68. Remember, this represents $68,000. So we can say the minimum cost spanning tree is $68,000. Now take a look at one more example where the information is given as a table. One thing we should recognize about the table is that each weight is given twice. The data in the upper right-hand corner is a duplication of data in the lower left-hand corner. For example, this value here of 3 represents the weight of edge BC, and so does this 3 here. So when finding the minimum cost, or the smallest weights, we'll just refer to this upper triangle here. Also notice how we have 6 vertices, so it can be helpful to put the vertices in a circle like this to keep track of the edges that are used. Now we want to find the edge with the least weight, or the minimum cost, which would be here at 3, which is edge BC. So edge BC is here. The next smallest weight, or minimum cost, would be here at 4, which is the weight of edge CE, which is here. The next smallest weight looks like it would be 11 here, which is the weight of edge BE. But notice how we can't use edge BE because it forms a circuit. So we'll go ahead and just cross that off so we know not to use it again. The next smallest weight or lowest cost would be here at 16, which is the weight of edge EF, which is here. The next smallest weight would be 17, the weight of edge AE, which is here. The next smallest weight or lowest cost is 19, which is the weight of edge BD, which is here, which does complete our spanning tree and create the minimum cost spanning tree. Notice how there's a path from any vertex to any other vertex, and no circuits are formed. We're also asked to find the total cost, so now we'll find the sum of these weights, which would be 3 plus 19 plus 17 plus 4 plus 16. Which equals 59. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.